Love is in the air everywhere I look around. Ooh, love is in the air with every sight and every sound. Oh, I know I'm really feeling it. I know it must be true, because I know that I am live now. Yes, I know that it really is true. I'm here again. Hello, good afternoon, good morning, good evening, wherever you happen to be watching in the world at the moment. Welcome to another live English stream with me, Mr. Duncan. Everything is working today. Everything is 100% working. Can I just point that out right now? Because I was here on Wednesday. Did you watch me on Wednesday with my special live English stream, talking all about my time in China? Because on Wednesday, it was the 10th anniversary of my return from China. So a couple of days ago, it was the 10th anniversary of my return to the UK. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much for all the lovely messages, all the kind thoughts and wishes. Many people saying, Mr. Duncan, we really did like your special live English lesson. It was so interesting seeing all of the photographs from your time in China. Perhaps I will do it again. Maybe in a few weeks' time, I will show you some more photographs from my time in China, because I did take a lot of photographs. And towards the end of my stay in China, I also did some filming as well around the city in which I was living. So thank you very much for that. I did receive a very special video message from a young man called Chu Shandong, who is actually living in the place that I was working. I was very surprised to receive this. If we have time, I will play it, but I'm not sure if we have time today, because I have a lot of things to talk about, and of course I will be involving you a little bit later on. But let us not forget that love is in the air. Love is definitely in the air. Are you feeling romantic? Because next week it is Valentine's Day. On the 14th of February, it will be Valentine's Day, a very special day for those in love. And of course, those who are looking for love. They are optimistically searching for that special person to share their lives with. So next week, I believe it's next Tuesday, it is Valentine's Day. So many of the things in today's program will be connected with romance and being in love. In fact, I have made an English lesson all about love. I have actually done that. There is an English lesson talking all about the subject of love. Learning English with Mr. Duncan, who is always in love with his viewers, every single one of them. Lesson 55 is my lesson all about the subject of love. There I am. Since the moment I first saw you, I knew that I must have you. You are the one I need. Only you can satisfy my desire. It was meant to be as soon as you came in the room. I must be with you. I must hold you. I have to have my lips near you. Please be mine. Oh, dear me. So there it is, the lesson all about love. So there is a lesson all about the subject of being in love and falling in love. It is available on my YouTube channel. Oh, look, a very nice romantic rose. And can you see all of the languages there? There are so many different ways to say, I love you. I love you. So there it is, my lesson all about being in love, falling in love, searching for love, and of course sometimes people lose love as well. So love is not always a happy experience. Sometimes finding love can be very difficult. Sometimes falling in love can be very difficult. And quite often losing love can be very difficult indeed. So there it is, the subject of love. That particular video is on my YouTube channel, and you can also find the link underneath this live stream. So if you look underneath this live stream, just below, you will see the link to my English lesson all about love. So the theme today is love and romance. A little bit later on, of course, I will be involving you with the live chat. You will have a chance to share your experiences of love, maybe, perhaps. Maybe there is someone you want to say I love you to. Ooh, maybe. So if you have a special love message, because it is Valentine's Day next Tuesday, the 14th of February, Valentine's Day, if you have a special love message to send to someone special in your life, you will have a chance a little bit later on. Also today, what is your most favorite romantic movie? Of course, there is nothing more romantic than going to the movies with the love of your life. A lot of people do it, especially after meeting someone for the first time. If you are going on a date, you date someone. To date someone means that you see them on a regular basis as a way of getting to know them. So to date someone is to go out with them. You go out with them, you date them, and you do things together. Quite often you will maybe go for a romantic dinner together, or maybe you go to the movies and see a very romantic movie, something very, very lovey-dovey. Ever so nice. So what is your most favorite romantic movie? I have a few of my own favorites. One of my favorite romantic movies must be Notting Hill. Has anyone seen that with Hugh Grant? Hugh Grant is in that, and that is a very romantic movie. That is one of my favorite romantic movies. But what is your most favorite romantic movie? You will have a chance to tell me a little bit later on when we open the live chat. Another question to ask you today: when does a person officially become old? So when do you stop being young and start being old? Now the reason why I'm asking this is because I had this very strange leaflet come through my door the other day. Can you see it? There it is. So this leaflet came through my door. It says, look at that, all together now, active for later life. Now I have a slight problem with this leaflet, and the problem I have is that this particular group that is encouraging people of a certain age to go along and do exercises to keep fit, they have put the age where people can go along as, can you see that? It says 50 plus. What does that mean? So what they are actually saying there, they are saying that if you are elderly, you must be 50 plus. So they are actually saying that if you are 50 years old or over, you are officially old. I must admit, I was a little bit shaken by this. When I first read this leaflet, I was a little bit shocked and slightly upset. In fact, I had a little cry upstairs on my bed. I was, oh, it's not fair. I'm old. Oh, nobody wants me. Because of this leaflet. It says there, can you see it? It says, now sessions are for those aged 50 plus, bringing the following benefits. Increase your balance and coordination. Can I just say there is nothing wrong with my balance and coordination? I mean, I will be 52 this year, and I can safely say that there is nothing wrong with my balance or coordination. So I'm very surprised that I received this leaflet, and they said that, look, 50 plus, apparently if you are over 50, you are now old. Officially old. What happened to life begins at 40? Of course, these days they say that life begins at 50. Why? Why are they saying that being 50 plus is old? What else does it say here? Yes, it says they will help you to complete daily tasks efficiently. Can I just say now, I have absolutely no problem whatsoever with my daily tasks. I can feed myself, okay. I can wash myself, okay. I can put my clothes on without getting confused. And I can go to the toilet by myself as well, so I have no problems with any of those things, even though I am over 50. So can we just get this straight here? Being 50 plus, just because you have reached the age of 50, it doesn't mean you're old, okay? So what do you think? When do you think you officially become old? What is an old person? Is an old person 40? Some people might think so. Is an old person 45? Is an old person 50? Or even 50 plus? Because apparently, if you are 50 plus, this is what you have to do. You have to be treated as if you are a geriatric. I'm sorry if I seem a little upset by this, but I was genuinely upset. I thought, I don't think being 50 plus, just because you are 50, it doesn't mean you're old. Please, please, someone tell me this. Just to cheer me up. So next Tuesday, it is Valentine's Day for all those who are looking for love, all those who want to fall in love, or perhaps you have already found that special person. Maybe you are already sharing your life with someone special. Talking of love and falling in love, outside my house at the moment, there are two pigeons sitting on the fence in my back garden, and we have a live webcam set up watching them. So at the moment there are two pigeons that are falling in love, and I thought, wouldn't that be lovely today to feature? So I'm going to feature this. I've called it the Love Pigeon Cam. So let's go now live to the Love Pigeon Cam just to see what's happening in my back garden. Here we go. This is a live camera set up watching my two love pigeons. Can you see them? Oh, isn't that romantic? Getting us in the mood for Valentine's Day. It's Valentine's Day next Tuesday. And there they are, a couple of love pigeons. Oh, look at that. Isn't that romantic?
Some people might say, Mr. Duncan, that's a little bit perverted. You are watching these two pigeons share an intimate moment. Well, let's just say it's a sort of nature documentary. Okay, let's call it that, shall we? But there it is, live as live can be, the love pigeon cam. Isn't that lovely? We will go back to the live love pigeon cam later, okay? So the camera is outside at the moment. We will take another look to see what the love pigeons are doing. Everything is romantic today because it is coming up to Valentine's Day. Now, I know in other parts of the world, for example, in China, they have a special day called Lover's Day. Lover's Day. And if I remember rightly, that concerns a story of two lovers who were separated in the heavens, and once a year they cross a bridge and meet together. That is called Lover's Day, and that is something that's celebrated in China. But next Tuesday it is Valentine's Day, next Tuesday. So for all of those who are looking for love, or if you are falling in love, maybe you have found a partner to share your life with. Oh, you are so lucky. And if you have any special messages that you wish to send to anyone in your life, someone special, maybe you want to say hello to your girlfriend or boyfriend, or maybe even say hello to someone you are in love with, but they don't know it. Ooh. So all of that coming up later on. And of course, I want to know what your favorite romantic movie is. If you have a favorite romantic movie, please let me know. Something very exciting happened this week on YouTube. Did you notice the slight changes on YouTube? Now, I noticed them. Because of these changes, my stream, my live stream on Wednesday didn't work. There were technical problems. This week, YouTube introduced live streaming on mobile phones and tablet devices. So that's a new thing that's happening. Would you ever go live on the internet? Would you ever do it? Would you ever live stream like this? A lot of people say, Mr. Duncan, it looks so easy when you are doing your live stream. It seems like a very easy thing to do. Let me tell you now, it is not easy. It's very stressful. Normally on a Friday, I spend a lot of time preparing this live stream. First of all, I have to make sure that all the equipment works properly, even though sometimes it doesn't. Like a couple of days ago when I had some technical problems. So YouTube has gone live this week with live streaming on mobile phones. So now you will have a chance on YouTube to actually go live on your mobile phones. Would you ever do that? Have you ever tried it? Let me know a little bit later on. I'm feeling very thirsty today, by the way, because my studio is very hot. I have the heating on because over the last couple of days here in the UK, it has become very, very cold. We have cold wind coming in at the moment from Siberia, all the way from Siberia. And this morning, there was a little bit of snow, just a little bit of snow outside my window. Not much, just a little. But it is very cold here at the moment. I don't know what the weather is like where you are, but here it is very, very chilly, to say the least. And that's the reason why I have my heating on today. It's very hot in here. But the problem is the heat dries your throat out. So my throat is a little bit dry. So excuse me, I need to drink some water. I love water. I love it so much. I've lost the top. Where's my top gone? Oh, there it is. I lost the top to my bottle. There it is. Coming up also today, I haven't mentioned it yet, we have word puzzles coming up. Words with all of the letters rearranged, and what you have to do is guess what the word is. Shall I show you the first word puzzle? Here it is very quickly. Here is today's first word puzzle. I will only give you 1 second to look at it. That was today's first word puzzle. Did you see it? Did you catch it? No. You should have been quicker. Do you enjoy going shopping? Do you like going around the shops? Now, I'm going to be very honest with you here. I do not like shopping. I went to town last week. I went to a place called Telford. Telford. A town that's very close to where I live. And I went shopping there, and I went into a certain store. I won't tell you the name of the store. Boots. It was Boots. And I was buying some toothpaste. I had to get some toothpaste and a new toothbrush. Because, of course, I am very capable of taking care of myself, even though I am 50 plus. So I was in the shop last week. I bought some toothpaste and I bought a toothbrush, and I went to pay at the checkout. And as I was paying, the woman behind the counter started to pressurize me into buying something else. Now, I don't know about you, but I hate it. I hate it when you are in a shop and the sales assistant pressurizes you into buying something. They say, here, try this, give this a try. Have you seen our latest product? Would you like to buy it? Would you like to try it? So I don't like that sort of sales. I don't like it when salespeople pressurize you. So that's one of the main reasons why I hate going shopping. If I do any shopping nowadays, I tend to do it online. I often go on the internet to do my shopping. I don't know what that is. What's that supposed to be? It looks like two spiders trying to escape from my underwear. In around about 5 minutes' time, we will be opening the live chat. So lots of things for you to talk about today. Are you romantic? Are you a romantic person? Is there someone in your life that you want to say hello to? You will have a chance in around about 4 minutes' time. Ooh, very interesting. Also, what is your most favourite romantic movie? Is there a movie that you love watching? A film where romance takes place. Two people fall in love. And whilst we are on the subject of love, do you believe in love at first sight? Shall I write that down? I'll write that down. Love at first sight. S-I-G-H-T. Do you believe in love at first sight? Wait there. Oh, can you see what's happened there? That says furt. Excuse me. That's better. Do you believe in love at first sight? Some people believe that you can find the love of your life straight away. As soon as you meet someone new, that person is the one. that you want. So do you believe in love at first sight? Do you believe that you can meet someone and straight away or instantly fall in love? Do you think that's true? It has happened to me in the past. That's all I'm saying. But do you believe in love at first sight? We are in a romantic mood today because it is Valentine's Day next week. And also it's Mr. Steve's birthday. Okay, back to the love pigeon cam. Let's see what the love pigeons are doing. There they are. This is a live picture outside. There are two pigeons. It looks like they are falling in love. Isn't that lovely? Oh, so romantic. So there are my love pigeons in my back garden at the moment, sitting on the fence. It looks like they are, oh, they're really getting along very well there. I hope they don't go any further, because YouTube might take me off the air. They might say, "Here, Mr. Duncan, you cannot have pigeons making love on your live English stream. It's forbidden." We are now coming up to 2:30. There it is, just to prove it. We are as live can be at the moment. Live, unless of course you are watching this later, in which case this isn't live. So if you are watching this later on, it isn't live. But if you are watching it now, it is live. Live chat. Let's open the live chat. Also, don't forget we have super chat now. If you would like to get to the top of the list, you can actually pay to be on top of my list. Ooh. So super chat is another new feature that YouTube has recently introduced. So if you want to get to the top of the list, maybe you have a romantic message to send to the love of your life. Isn't that lovely? Something very, very romantic. Are you afraid of spiders? The reason why I mention that is because I've noticed over the last couple of days that all the spiders are starting to come out again. All of the spiders are starting to appear around my house. So I think that spring is definitely on the way. So here are some questions for you today. Your favourite romantic movie. Is there a special person in your life that you want to say hello to? You will have a chance to in a moment. Do you believe in love at first sight? There it is. Do you believe in love at first sight? Do you think it is possible to fall in love instantly? You will have a chance to tell me because the live chat is now about to be activated. Love is in the air today because Valentine's Day is on the way. Oh, also coming a little bit later on, we have some flash words and a flash phrase as well coming later on. So don't forget that. We have some flash words and flash phrases as well. Live chat is now working. Let's have a look who is on the live chat. Let's just open it out so we can see clearly what is going on. I'm very happy to see that the technology is working today. I'm very, very pleased. So here we go, the live chat is open. Do you believe in love at first sight? Is there a special person that you want to say hello to today? Maybe someone that you are in love with. Oh. Anzonic is here. Anzonic is talking about Wednesday's live stream. Mr. Duncan, fortunately you came back from China. You could have been robbed again. Yes, of course. If you saw my live stream on Wednesday, I did mention that whilst living in China, I was robbed. Two guys robbed me with a knife. It wasn't very pleasant. So thank you, Anzonic, for that. At least I'm here still on YouTube, safe and sound. Victoria says hello. Bogdan is here as well. Hello, Bogdan. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Nice to see you. Ellis Angela is here as well. Algerian Berber says, when you think you are old, at this time you are old. Oh, okay. I suppose that's one way of looking at it. Because I had a leaflet. I had this piece of paper come through my door during the week. And they said that this group that they have launched is open to people who are 50 plus. Now, I personally don't think that 50 is old. For various reasons. One, of course, because I'm over 50. So, and I don't think I'm old. So I think you're right. Yes. The thing is, you are as old as you feel. So if you feel young, I suppose it would be fair to say that you are young. Does that make sense? Yvonne Lee is here. Hello, Yvonne Lee. Welcome. Where are you watching? Where are you? Yvonne Lee says, wow, this is the first time to join the live chat. Welcome, Yvonne. Yvonne Lee, where are you watching? Victoria says, I don't believe in love at first sight. And I love my husband. So Victoria's husband loves you. Yes, isn't that lovely? Julie G says, Mr. Duncan, I do believe in love at first sight. I believe that it's possible. So Julie believes that it is possible to meet someone for the first time and fall in love with them. Isn't that lovely? Ellis Angela says, I don't believe in love at first sight. Today is my birthday. Happy birthday to Ellis. Happy birthday to you. It's your birthday today. Ahmed Fares. Hi, Mr. Duncan. I like the movie Before Sunset. I do not believe in love at the first sight. Some people believe it's possible to fall in love straight away, whilst others doubt it. They doubt that it's possible. Anne Tu Chuan says, hello, Mr. Duncan. Hello, Anne. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. It's Mr. Duncan with Live English. Live on a Friday afternoon. It is Friday, February the 10th today. Next week, it is Valentine's Day, and that is the reason why we are talking all about love today. Ariel Castilla says, hi, Mr. Duncan. You promised to send me a gift through the post, but I did not receive it. Ariel Castilla, did you not? I think that was in response to one of my little questions, wasn't it? Oh, okay, then I will have a look at that. I will have a look into it. Okay, I think that was one of my, maybe one of my t-shirts, I think so. Thank you for reminding me. Jerry Mouse, hi, you. Hi, Jerry, how are you today? Victoria Mira says, Mr. Duncan, you look very young. Thank you very much for that. It takes a long time to get all of this prepared during the morning. It takes about 2 hours. Lots of scrubbing, lots of scraping. Rekha Kuna says, hello, Mr. Duncan, nice to see you. I definitely don't think you are old. Now, I don't consider myself as old, but this leaflet that came through my door, now this, I suppose I should explain that this is all about keeping healthy when you become elderly. So this is a sort of activity for people who are elderly, but they want to get some exercise. But I don't think that 50 plus is where you should start. I think maybe 60 or over. So when do we officially become old? When we start becoming old? What do you think? I don't think it's 50. I think maybe 60 or 65, maybe 66. So once you become over 60, I think we could say that you are old. Whew, it's a big subject, that. Very big subject. Yvonne Lee says, I am watching in Taiwan. It is now coming up to 20 to 11 at night in Asia. Thank you, Yvonne. Can you believe that I used to live in China? I used to live in China. Alex Lav says, hello, Mr. Duncan. Are you afraid of mice? I'm not afraid of mice, but I am afraid of rats. I don't like rats because they're so big and they have those really long, thick tails and they move very quickly. So mice are lovely. I think mice are nice. Mice are nice. Simona Badisha says, hi to everyone here. I think 60 plus is old. I agree. I am 45 and I feel very young. I think so. As someone pointed out earlier, they said, Mr. Duncan, you are old, or you are as old as you think you are. So if you feel young, you are young. So I like to think that I am young at heart. So young at heart means that however old you are, you feel young inside. So yes, maybe. Jerry Mouse. Hello to you, Jerry, again. Lots of people in the live chat. It's moving very fast today. So if I miss you out on the list, please don't shout at me, because I have lots of people to say hello to. Martha Poland says, hello, Mr. Duncan. My dad fell in love from the first sight when he first met my mother. Oh, isn't that lovely? That's so romantic. I think, and this is just my opinion, I think that love at first sight is very romantic. It doesn't happen to everyone. I know that. But I think that love at first sight is such a beautiful thing. Do you have a favorite romantic movie? Is there a romantic movie that you like or enjoy watching? Do you do anything special on Valentine's? Now, some people go out for a meal, or maybe if they are a couple, they will buy each other presents, little gifts, maybe chocolate. Ellis Angela says, actually, I'm in love with you, Mr. Duncan. Oh my gosh, I'm so embarrassed now. Am I going red? I think so. Let us have a quick look at the word puzzle. Here it is, today's word puzzle. I will show it to you one more time. There it is, today's word puzzle. It is one word, just a single word. Let's also have a look at a flash word, shall we? Let's have a look at a flash word. We will go over to the other side of the studio and see what today's first flash word is. Flash word. Do you believe in love at first sight? Some people do, and some people don't. Let's have a look at today's first flash word. There it is. Can you see it? I hope so. I hope you can see it clearly on your screen. Today's first flash word is sycophant. Sycophant. The word sycophant is an English noun. The word sycophant is an English noun that means to act or behave in an obsequious or fawning manner. That is to say, someone who agrees with another person or listens to them with the intention of gaining favor.
Oh.
A sycophant will suck up to someone by pretending to agree with whatever the other person says or does. He always agrees with everything the boss says. What a sycophant. He always agrees with everything the boss says. What a sycophant. The verb form of sycophant is sycophantic. To behave in a sycophantic way. A sycophant can be described as a creep, a crawler, an arse kisser, a boot licker. A sycophant creeps, fawns, crawls, grovels. They kiss ass. They brown nose. They suck up. So, there it is. Sycophant. The word sycophant means to agree or go along with what another person is saying. As a way of gaining favor. So you do it, but you don't mean it. You are a sycophant. That's a great word. So that's today's first flash word. Some more flash words and a flash phrase coming a little bit later on. But now it is time to return to the romance.
I feel love. I feel love.
Love, 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 love. Are you in love with someone? Is there someone in your life that you want to say hello to? You will have a chance today on the live chat. Andrew Molloy Chikoff says, hi everyone. There was a TV show called Love at First Sight. So surely it exists. I think you are talking about reality TV. Maybe it was a reality TV show. You do realize that sometimes reality TV shows are actually fake. Ooh, Mr. Duncan, you are so naughty. Julie G, Mr. Duncan, do you believe in love at first sight? I think so, because you are a romantic soul. Me? Yes, I think it's possible. Yes, of course, I think it's possible to fall in love. To fall in love at first sight. So some people believe it is possible to fall in love after meeting someone for the first time. Ciao, Mr. Duncan. Saturino Farandola is here. You look so dapper in your red t-shirt. I believe in profit at first sight. I'm not sure what you mean by that. Do you mean money? Oh, okay. Eugene says, one of my favorite romantic movies is While You Were Sleeping, an American romantic comedy. Yes, who was in that? Who was in While You Were Sleeping? Now, I vaguely remember it. It's a very old film, isn't it? It's not a new movie. It's quite old. I think it wasn't it Sandra Bullock? I want to say Sandra Bullock. I might be wrong. And if I remember rightly, she takes care of a man who is in a coma. He is in a coma. Coma. C-O-M-A. Coma. So that means he is in a very deep sleep from which he cannot be woken. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Greetings from Colombia. You are the best. John Meadows Towers. Thank you, John. I have a very dry throat today because my studio is hot. Are you enjoying the live webcam? We have some live pigeons. There they are. Let's just have a look. There they are, look. Live pigeons. They are love pigeons. Can you see? They are deeply, deeply in love with each other. Isn't that lovely? It's so romantic. So there they are in my back garden at the moment. They are falling in love. In fact, I have a feeling that they have already fallen in love. Steady. Steady. Calm down. Calm down. Steady. That's it. Take it easy. Take it slowly. That's it. Oh, I think they heard me. I think they heard what I said then. They reacted to me. John Meadows, thank you very much for your comment. Ariel says some people work after 70. That is true, yes. Here in the UK, the retirement age is 65. But I think they are going to raise it to 67 or maybe even 70 in the future. So yes, I think you're right there. Ariel, some people do work after the retirement age. Lucy says, I like your t-shirt. Do you like my t-shirt? My red t-shirt? Yes. It is very retro. Retro. Do you want to see that word? Retro. R-E-T-R-O. This t-shirt is very retro. Now that word describes something that is from the past or something that was around many years ago that might not be around now. So something that relates or references something from the past. So this t-shirt is very retro because as you can see on it there are some cassettes, and of course not many people use cassettes anymore. They are now out of date. They are very old-fashioned. So if you reference something that is old-fashioned or something from the past, you can say it is very retro. Retro. Andrew says, you are old when trying to tie your shoelace. And you are thinking of what to do. By the way, whilst you are bending over. I'm not sure what you mean by that, but I do get what you mean in a certain way. When you get older, it becomes hard to concentrate. I think that's what you're saying there. It becomes very hard to concentrate. Olga says, hello, Mr. Duncan. One of my favorite romantic movies is Love Actually. Love Actually is a very famous British movie. Once again, starring Hugh Grant. I have noticed that Hugh Grant, who is a British actor, he has starred in many romantic movies. One of my favourite romantic movies, one of mine, is Notting Hill. Notting Hill. Are you afraid of lizards? No, I am not afraid of lizards because I have one in my studio. Can you see my little iguana? There he is, sitting in the corner. So I'm not afraid of lizards because I have one in my studio. Catherine Foggs says, I am nearly 60, but I don't feel old. Perhaps others think I am old, but actually I don't care as long as I can do whatever I wish. Yes, Catherine, I think you are right. There is a proverb, there is a saying in English, you are only as old as you feel. So if you feel young, you are young. Thank you very much for that. If you want to say hello to anyone today, if you have a special message to send to someone that you love, you, of course, can. You are very welcome to. Martha Poland says, my dad is now 50. My father is 50. And he isn't old, just like you. Thank you. I'm very pleased to hear that. That is very reassuring. Thank you. Ellis Angela says, Beauty and the Beast. They are making a new version of that this year, aren't they? There is a new version of Beauty and the Beast. I think it's a movie, and I think it's coming out this year, if I'm not mistaken. Beauty and the Beast. Of course, I am the beauty, not the beast. John Meadows, could it be possible? Sometimes it's just attraction to a beautiful person and not true love. Oh, yes. John, you are right. I suppose that could happen. So maybe you fall in love with someone, but it's not true love. It's just something that is passing by. Michael Sue is here. Oh, Michael. Oh, better be careful. I should be careful. I will get a copyright strike from YouTube. Oh, Michael Sue likes the movie Titanic. That is a very romantic movie. I've never seen Titanic, but please don't tell me what happens at the end. I don't want to know. So please don't spoil it. Don't spoil it. I haven't seen Titanic all the way through. So don't tell me how it ends, okay? I don't want to know the ending. Frank Uberia says, hello from the Dominican Republic. Hello to the Dominican Republic. How are you today? Are you okay? I really hope so. Kalun Hitchem says, it is possible to fall in love at first sight. Yes, it is possible. It can happen. Hung Nguyen says, also Titanic. Also likes the romantic movie Titanic. Very romantic indeed. But what is your favourite romantic movie? Do you have a favourite romantic movie? Is there someone in your life, a special person, that you want to say hello to today? Because it's Valentine's Day next Tuesday, on Tuesday the 14th of February. Lucy says, Little Red Riding Hood. I'm not sure if that's a movie. Is that a movie? I thought that was a fairy tale. Mr. Duncan. Hello, dear, says Pedro Belmont. Hello, Pedro. Welcome. How is life treating you? Life is treating me quite well, even though I found out this week that if you are 50 plus, if you are over 50, apparently you are now old. That's very bad news for me. Very bad news indeed. Andrew Molai Chikoff says, maybe it's because of the Gulf Stream. I'm not sure what that refers to. Welcome, Algerian Berber. Welcome. You have guessed the puzzle word correctly. Well done. Well done. Ah, you've got it right. Oleg Bijan says, yes, something that is retro is vintage. Something vintage, something from the past that is now in the present. Something that is from the past in the present. So you can say it is retro, vintage. That's a great word, vintage. Reda Abid says, hello, Mr. Duncan, how are you? I really like your videos. Thank you very much for that. Don't forget, there are lots of English teaching videos on my YouTube channel. Over 300 videos on my YouTube channel. Talking of love, there is also a lesson on my YouTube channel discussing the subject of love. So for those who are feeling romantic at the moment, you can go to my YouTube channel and you can watch my special English lesson all about the subject of love. It is lesson 55. So lesson 55 on my YouTube channel is a lesson all about love. Since the moment I first saw you, I knew that I must have you. You are the one I need. Only you can satisfy my desire. It was meant to be as soon as you came in the room. I must be with you. I must hold you. I have to have my lips near you. Please be mine. So there it is, my ever so very, very romantic English lesson talking all about the subject of love. If you want to watch that video later, you can. The link to this lesson is underneath this live stream. So there it is, my love lesson for those who are falling in love. Oh, sorry, I had a little romantic moment there. I hope you don't mind. It's 3 o'clock now in the UK. I don't know what time it is where you are. I'm not sure. Maybe it is morning. Maybe it is afternoon. Perhaps it's evening. Or maybe it's tomorrow. So perhaps you are watching me now on Saturday. Pathatik Dorvak says, Mr. Duncan, why did you change your hair? I mean, Trump's hair. Well, I just wanted a change. Sometimes a change is as good as a rest. That's what they say. Ellis says, is Mr. Lomax still in America? Yes, he is in the United States. Yes, I think he's going to stay there. I have a feeling he's trying to get citizenship, even though Donald Trump did try to throw him out. But of course, that has all come to an end now. So it looks like Mr. Lomax is going to stay in America, which is very sad for me. Lucy says, I miss Mr. Lomax. I miss that monkey. Oh, there he is. Can you see him? Just behind me. There he is. There's Mr. Lomax. Can you see him? There he is. Mr. Lomax. Hi, everybody. I'm enjoying this video. I'm afraid I can't read your name there because it is in some different characters and my computer can't read it. Elias says, Mr. Duncan, I learned the phrasal verb. It was no easy. Do you mean it was not easy? Can we have a close look at your iguana? That's a very strange offer. I have some very strange things said to me when I'm on the internet, but no one has ever asked to have a close look at my iguana. Ooh. Hi, Mr. Duncan. Hung Najuan. Hi, Hung. How are you today? Judy G says, this lesson is fun. I'm glad you think so, and I'm very grateful that you have decided to drop by. Let's have a look outside because we have the live webcam. We have a live camera outside watching the love pigeons. Let's have a look. There they are. So we have the love pigeons. They are in love. And they're still together. Isn't that lovely? Oh, it's so romantic. Oh. Do you know what I'm thinking now? Do you know what I'm wondering? I'm trying to work out what the difference is. How can you tell the difference between a male and a female? Because pigeons look the same. They look very similar to each other. So how do they know? How do they know which is the male and which is the female? I'm just imagining some very embarrassing situations now. Or maybe not. Maybe not. Oh, yeah, they're having a rest now, look. Let's leave them. They're having a little rest. Okay, let's leave the love pigeons for a while. Yvonne Lee has written to Simona saying, yes, I like that movie as well. Hi, Mr. Duncan. Van Nguyen, thank you very much for that. Lucy asks, Mr. Duncan, are you falling in love? I'm in love with everyone. I love all of my viewers, especially. I love you and 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 you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you as well. Isn't that nice? Lucy Grazon says, Mr. Duncan, have you ever been to Colombia? I have never been to Colombia. Never been to Colombia ever in my life. Elias Elnata asks, Mr. Duncan, what do you think about Donald Trump? Theresa May, Marine Le Pen, and Bolsonaro. The world is in a new way. Well, the world is definitely different. It's definitely different from what it was a year ago. Definitely. Yes, the world is changing. Lots of big things happening. Lots of big things have happened over the last couple of weeks. So yes, lots of things happening in the world. Reka Kuna says, those pigeons are so lovely. Oh, my little love pigeons are outside at the moment because Valentine's Day is coming and they are getting very romantic. Mr. Duncan, you have provided my English language. I really appreciate it, says Saeed. Saeed, thank you very much. You are welcome. Everyone is welcome. Wherever you are watching in the world, wherever you are right now, I welcome everyone. In Poland, according to Martha, it is 4 o'clock now in Poland. It is now just after 3 o'clock here. So in Poland, you must be 1 hour ahead. An hour ahead. I see. Andrew says, I think there was a meal after all those hot words. Oh, I see. Yes. Do you mean my English video lesson? Yes, there was. You are right. Ellis says, we love you so much. Do you mean me? Thank you. Mr. Duncan, do you mind wearing a Theresa May wig next time? I don't have a Theresa May wig. I do have a Theresa May dress. And I have Theresa May shoes. But I don't have the wig. I will see what I can do, okay? I will try my best. Maybe next week. Mr. Duncan, are those pigeons tied to the fence? No, the pigeons are not tied to the fence, definitely. they are in love. They are so in love. They can't move. They can't move. They are paralyzed with love. But are you? Are you in love? Is there someone you want to say hello to? Is there? We have a word puzzle. I will give you the answer in a moment. There it is, the word puzzle. YouTube live streaming started this week on your mobile phone. So many people now can actually go live on the internet across YouTube on their phones and tablets. Have you done it? Have you tried it yet? Because of course, Facebook has been doing live streaming for a very long time. So I think YouTube are trying to compete with Facebook. But here I am. I'm here, of course, live as usual. Don't forget, I am here every Friday. Every single Friday, I'm here from 2 o'clock UK time, 2 p.m. UK time, every Friday. I hope. Elias says, talking about love, the UK has a lot of romantic places. Well, round where I live, there are lots of lovely places to go walking. So you can take lots of very romantic walks very near to where I live. So yes, you are right. Many countries around the world have a sort of romantic theme. For example, in France, a lot of people think that the French are very romantic. Some people say that Italians are very romantic. Anja Matala says, what is that black and white photo on the wall behind you? Well, there are quite a few. There is the Happy Valentine's Day heart. Then there is a big kiss from a pair of lips. And also, oh, I see. Yes, there is the BAFTA award. Now, this Sunday, there is a special award taking place. It is the British Academy of Film and Television Awards. Most people call them the BAFTAs. I will write that down. B-A-F-T-A. Here it is. BAFTA. BAFTA. And that is an abbreviation of British Association of Film and Television Awards. British Film and Television Awards. And they take place next Sunday. And the thing you can see behind me over there, can you see it just there? There. That is the award that you get. When you win a BAFTA, when you get a BAFTA, that is what you get. You get one of those little statues. Can you see it? There it is. And of course, later this month, we have the Oscars as well. The Oscar ceremony taking place on, I think it's on February 27th. 27th of February. I think so. Hello from Spain, Mr. Duncan. I am in love with Mr. Lomax. Really? Although I remember the episode in which you were electrocuted by him. Yes. Do you remember that in my full English episode? One of my full English lessons when Mr. Lomax electrocuted me. He nearly killed me. Saturino Farandola. Valentine's Day is the celebration of every idiot who thinks to be loved, but he is only fooled. Oh, Saturino, that's very cynical. Some people don't believe in real love, but I do. I like to believe it. I'm quite romantic. I will be honest. I am quite a romantic person. Very Yes, romantic. Martha Poland, have you got any Valentine's cards? Not yet. It's a little too early, but maybe next week. Maybe I will get a Valentine's card. Ooh. Elias Elnata, what does a date with people that you never meet physically? I mean, the butterfly is running in the stomach. I'm just trying to work out what you are saying there. Maybe before a date. So before you meet someone, before you go on a date with someone, perhaps you feel very nervous. You feel very nervous. So perhaps you have butterflies in your stomach. So the feeling of being very nervous and apprehensive, we can say that you have butterflies in your stomach. So perhaps you are going on your first date. You are meeting someone on a date for the first time. Yes, perhaps you will feel very nervous. Lucy says, I really like the video when Mr. Lomax electrocuted you. Thanks a lot. Giovanni De Leo, I just wanted to say a big hello to the best teacher in the world. Do you mean me? Oh, okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. I wasn't sure if you meant me, you see. Because, you know, I'm so modest. Ellis says, Ellis writes, love is the best thing in the world sometimes. I think so. I think it's nice to fall in love. There is nothing wrong with being in love. Carlos A says, I have heard that pigeons can be called rats with wings. Rats with wings. Some people do say that, yes. Some people don't like pigeons. They think they are very annoying. They think they are a pest. They treat them as if they are vermin. Vermin. Ooh, I like that word. Vermin. Pedro Belmont says, Mr. Duncan, I want to show the pictures of the Amazon Opera House for you when I was there. If you want to send a picture, you can. I will have a look on my mobile phone if you want to send it. You are welcome, Pedro. You can see my email address is just under there. My email address, email mrduncan@ymail.com. If you want to send something to me, feel free. Feel free to do so. Infatuation is the word puzzle answer, says Simona. Yes, you are right. Here it is. Today's word puzzle. Only two people got it right. Today's word puzzle, the first word puzzle today, is infatuation. Infatuation. The word infatuation. But what does it mean, Mr. Duncan? What does infatuation mean? Infatuation is an intense but short-lived passion or admiration for someone or something. So, infatuation. An intense but short-lived passion or admiration for someone or something. So there it is, today's first word puzzle. A very romantic word. A word that sometimes is related to love. Infatuation. We will have another word puzzle in a moment. If we have time, we will have another one. But right now, we are going to have another flash word. Or I know what. Let's have a flash phrase, shall we? Shall we? Okay, let's go over to the other side of the studio. going over to the other side of the studio now.
Come on! Come on, everyone! Come on! Come and join me here in the corner of the studio. So here we go. We have now a flash phrase. Are you ready? Here it is. Take it with a pinch of salt. To take it with a pinch of salt, or take something with a pinch of salt. Take it with a pinch of salt is an English phrase. The phrase "take it with a pinch of salt" is an English expression that means don't take something as fact or truth. If you take something with a pinch of salt, it means that you don't actually believe what you've been told. I would take what he said with a pinch of salt. You take something with a pinch of salt when you feel suspicious or doubtful of what someone said. We have been advised to take everything she promised with a pinch of salt. To take something with a pinch of salt means that you have doubts about the honesty of what was said or done. You take it with a pinch of salt. So there it is, today's flash phrase. Take it with a pinch of salt. You hear something said or you see something done and you don't believe that it's true. You take it with a pinch of salt. Another flash word coming a little bit later on. If we have time, we have one flash word still to come. So don't go away.
Don't leave me this way. Please.
Don't leave me this way. Don't leave me this way. Let's have a look outside. Let's see what the love pigeons are doing at the moment. Can you see the love pigeons? They are so in love. Ah, oh, that is so romantic. Love pigeons. And one of my viewers asked earlier, Mr. Duncan, have you tied these pigeons to the fence? No, I haven't. I haven't tied them to the fence, honestly. They are there enjoying each other's company. I didn't force them to sit there. Nothing like that. What will you be doing during Valentine's Day, Mr. Duncan? I'm not sure yet. I haven't got any plans. Maybe something surprising will happen. Maybe I will have a nice surprise on Valentine's Day. Who knows? Joanna R. says, my grandparents would say that Valentine's Day is too American, but I don't care. Well, people celebrate Valentine's Day in many parts of the world. Sometimes some countries have Valentine's Day on different days. As I mentioned earlier, in China, they have Lover's Day. Lover's Day. So a day especially for those who are in love. Very similar to Valentine's Day. Julieta says, the best teacher ever. I am your big fan. Thank you, Julieta. Thank you. And you are very welcome. You are very welcome. Saturino says, I am right. I said, I will buy you a big tube of Bacci Perugina. And she replied that she is on a diet and it would be getting and would instead be getting a gold ring. I'm a little confused by that, but what I think you're saying there, Saturino, is you was going to offer some food, but instead she wanted a gold ring. Wow. Mahmoud Hamid says, I never take your lessons with a pinch of salt. I'm very pleased to hear that. I'm very pleased that you think and feel that way. MISC says, hello, Mr. Duncan. Are you happy? Are you okay? Yes, I am. And I hope you are as well. Tuan Fong. Hello, Tuan. Hello, Mr. Duncan. I'm so sorry I'm late, but I want to fall in love with your pigeons. Ah, yes. Romance and love is in the air today because Valentine's Day is coming next Tuesday. Poor Saturino, says Ellis. So Saturino, is that your own experience? Is that your experience? Wow. So you offered food, but instead you had to buy a diamond ring, a gold ring. Maybe a gold diamond ring. Wow. Anzonic says, do you believe in love at first sight or should I walk by again? That's very good. I like that one. Yes. So maybe you meet someone and perhaps they don't even notice you, but you notice them. So you have to go by again. You have to pass them by again to try and get their attention so they will fall in love with you. Lucy says, those pigeons are so cute. They are. And they are madly, passionately in love. In Brazil, Valentine's Day is on June the 12th. I will make a note of that. June the 12th. Matthew Boom says, Mr. Duncan, I looked on the internet, but I can't find I can't find a Theresa May wig. I'm sure I can find something that looks like Theresa May's wig. Not that I'm saying that Theresa May wears a wig, just in case Theresa May is watching and she wants to sue me, because that would be very awkward. But yes, I maybe one week, maybe perhaps one week, I will dress up as Theresa May. Perhaps that will be my last ever English lesson. Maybe. Vietnam loves you so much, says Oi Tuan Lin Oi. Oh, okay. Thank you very much for that. And a big hello to Vietnam. I know I have lots and lots of people watching in Vietnam. I've never been to Vietnam. No. Temp Tam asks if I've ever been to Vietnam. No, I've never been. Ever. Apparently in Russia, Valentine's Day is on July the 8th. The 8th of July is Valentine's Day in Russia. I am Ahmad from Sweden. Do you like classical music? And which composer is your favorite? I am a very big fan of classical music. One of my favorite composers is Mahler. Mahler. A lot of his music is very emotional. So I do like Mahler very much. And maybe a little bit of Elgar as well. I like Elgar. And of course Mozart and Beethoven, you know. Zaid says, hello from Russia. A big privet to you, watching in Russia at the moment. Alex says, apparently February the 14th is also Valentine's Day in Russia. So not the 8th of July, but the 14th of February. A slight disagreement going on there. Saturino says, I am sorry I am not rich like Donald Trump. And unfortunately, she is not Melania. Oh, okay. I'm saying nothing. I'm saying nothing for that. Nothing. Lucy says, you look so red today, Mr. Duncan. Do I look red? Yes, I've got my red hat and my red shirt and, of course, my red love heart and my big red kissing lips.
Ooh.
Because Valentine's Day is on the way. A lot of people want to see the love pigeons again. Let's have a look at the love pigeons in my garden. Are they still there? Yes, there they are. Look, the love pigeons are still in my garden. Oh, isn't that lovely? They are so in love. But which is which? Which is the male and which one is the female? So it's
a little bit confusing, I think.
I wonder if they ever get it wrong. I wonder if a male ever lands and starts doing that to another male. Not that there's anything wrong with that. We should have some romantic music, really, shouldn't we? Oh, isn't that lovely? Jamila Borg says, hello from Malta. Malta. Didn't you have some snow a few weeks ago in Malta? Wasn't it snowing in Malta? Maybe last week or the week before? Lucy says, you keep bothering those pigeons. It's okay. They don't know we're watching. It's all right. Carlos A says, last lesson. No, there isn't a last lesson. What I said was, if I dressed as Theresa May. Theresa May is the British Prime Minister. And she's a lady. If I dressed as Theresa May, perhaps that would be my last English lesson. It's very cold here. A very, very cold day here. We had a little bit of snow this morning. I got very excited because we had a little bit of snow. Do you enjoy going shopping? I told you a story earlier about my experience last week when I went into a certain shop. Boots. It was Boots. And the lady behind the counter, while I was paying for my goods, she was trying to sell me something at the same time. She kept trying to sell it. Have this. Try this. Go on. And I didn't want to. I didn't want to have it. I didn't want to try it. She kept pushing it. So I hate it when you go to the shops and the sales assistant is very pushy. Very pushy. I always remember in China, whenever you went into a big department store, there would always be people greeting you as you went through the door. And they would say, Huailing Huailing, Huailing Huailing. It's true. I think it means welcome. Welcome. How old are you, Mr. Duncan? I am probably older than you. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Is your watch a calculator? You mean this? Yes, this is also a calculator. This watch is very old. It's very retro. In fact, this watch is vintage. It's a vintage watch. This watch is about 20 years old. In fact, maybe older than that. It's a very old watch, this. So I've had this watch for many, many years. So yes, my watch does have a calculator. And it's a very old watch. I've had this for many years. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Yes, my Peter Lynch asked the question about my watch. SAA has written something. I'm not quite sure what that says. I hope it's not rude. Do you know about the book Word by Word Dictionary that has CDs?
Do you mean that, is there a word dictionary that's available on CD or CD-ROM? I think there is. I know that the Oxford Dictionary is available on CD-ROM. I'm pretty sure of it. Now, Juan Chin asks, Mr. Duncan, are you married? Am I married? What do you think? Do you think I'm married? Do you know that your clothes are red, but in front of the curtain, they seem to be red-brown? That's probably because of the lighting, you see. The lighting over there is a little different to the lighting here. It's a little different from over there. Hello, Mr. Duncan from Vietnam, Van Long Van. Hello, Van Long Van. It's nice to see you. Welcome. You are very welcome today. So do you like going into the shops? I don't like going shopping in person. So I do a lot of my shopping on the internet. Can you see what I'm doing there? That's typing, you see. I'm typing. So yes, I do that. I always shop online. I don't go to the shops in person because I find it very stressful. Very stressful indeed. When you were in China, what happened on Valentine's Day? Lots of people gave me presents and cards on Lover's Day. So in China, they have Lover's Day. Lover's Day. So a day for lovers. Sandro, Mr. Duncan. What happened last week? You seemed in a bad mood. Yes, I was in a bad mood last week, but I'm not going to talk about that today. I don't want to talk about that, but I was in a very bad mood because YouTube, they keep on upsetting me and making me very angry. But today I'm okay because I'm with you. I feel so much better. Marcello says, hello, Mr. Duncan. I know I'm late, but it is commonly said, better late than never. I agree. That's a very good phrase. I like that. I like it. Sard says, I think you are not married. Why? Why do you think that? Is it because I'm so happy? Abdelaziz says, Mr. Duncan, you are crazy. I am not crazy. My mother had me tested. Joanna R., I do not like to buy in the supermarkets because the guards observe the customers very indiscreetly. I don't like that. I don't like it when you go into a shop and people watch you because they think you are going to steal something. I hate that. I hate going into a shop. And then the people working in the shop, they all start watching you because they think you are going to steal something. They think you are a shoplifter. Shoplifter. That's a great word, that. Shoplifter. Shall I write that down for you? Shoplifter. A person who is a shoplifter. There it is. Shoplifter. Now, this word describes a person who goes into shops. They go into a shop and they steal things. So that is what a shoplifter is. Shoplifter. Mr. Duncan, I have sent the pictures already. Please check your phone. I will check my phone, Pedro Belmont. We have 21 minutes to go. In 21 minutes' time, I will disappear. I will go. So let's have a look. Pedro Belmont. Let's have a look here, shall we? I wish I had my reading glasses, but I'm not wearing my reading glasses. I don't have them. So excuse me a moment. Oh dear, I am getting old. Let's have a look, Pedro. Let's see what you've sent. Let's have a look. Oh, you've sent me lots of photographs. I can't show all of these because there's too many. It will take me a very long time to show these. So I will show everyone a couple of them. Oh, isn't that nice? So there is a photograph sent by Pedro just a few moments ago. There it is. Thank you, Pedro, for that. But where is it? Can you tell me where it is? Where is the place? Where is it? Thank you, Pedro. Let's have a look at another photograph. I think we have time. Let's have a look at another one very quickly. Oh, I see. Now we have Pedro with someone else. Maybe it's one of your friends. I don't know. I'm not sure. But there is Pedro Belmont. Pedro is on the left. But I don't know who the other guy is. I don't know who the guy with the beard is. I have no idea. Maybe he is a tourist. Thank you, Pedro, for that. Just to prove that this is live, you can, of course, send me photographs. And if I get to see them, I will show them live. So there we go. Tuan Fong says, Mr. Duncan, your voice is very nice. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Hang the Jock says, I have discovered an interesting thing, your face. Sometimes your face looks like Mr. Bean, and your gesture is so funny.
Hello. Hello. My name is Mr. Bean. Okay.
I don't think I look like Mr. Bean, do I? Do I really?
Yeah.
Edwige Mendoza says, is it allowed to get married for the same sex person in your country? Yes, it is allowed here in the UK. It is allowed. So if two men want to get married or two ladies want to get married, da, 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 they can. The pigeon is telling the other pigeon, I will take the mortgage for our nest. I like that. Yes. Maybe they are going to move in together somewhere. Let's have a look at our live pigeon camera. Let's see what they're doing. Oh, it looks like they're fighting. Are they fighting there? Oh dear. I'm not sure if that's love or violence. It's hard to tell the difference. Oh dear. Oh, I think the one on the right is the male. I think so. Oh, isn't that lovely? There they are. They've been sitting there for ages. Oh, isn't that lovely? Love pigeons in my garden. Isn't that nice? Thank you, Andrew. Yes, perhaps they are going to move into a new nest. But who will pay the mortgage? Who? Ahmed asks, what is the meaning of clumsy? If you are clumsy, it means you are careless. You don't take care. You always have accidents. You always drop things or break things. You are very clumsy. Clumsy. I will write the word down for you. Clumsy. So if you're very clumsy, a clumsy person always has accidents. They always break things or drop things. They are very clumsy. Anna Pham, do you have any pets, Mr. Duncan? No, I don't. Do you like the movie Romeo and Juliet? Oh, yes. There was a recent movie called Romeo and Juliet with Leonardo DiCaprio. Yes, I know which one you mean. Yes. Very romantic story. But it has such a sad ending. So sad. Mr. Duncan, you scared me at first because you looked like Negan from The Walking Dead. Oh, really?
I don't watch The Walking Dead. I've never seen it. There are many TV shows and movies that I've never seen that many other people have. So I have never watched The Walking Dead. Also, I have never watched Game of Thrones. I've never seen it. Never, ever, ever, never. Mr. Duncan, thanks a lot from Egypt. I hope you are good today. I feel great today. I feel on top of the world, and I hope you do too. Najuan Chin says, please answer this. Ooh. I might not now. Do you have any idea for me to prepare for my next English exam? I am in grade 6. Well, it depends what the exam is, because there are many different types of English exam. So maybe the exam is for your speaking, or maybe for your writing, or maybe for your listening, or maybe for your comprehension. So it really depends on what type of exam it is, what type of exam you are going to take. Mr. Duncan, you are so happy. I'm always happy. Most of the time, I am happy. Pedro Belmont says, the picture is located in my city, Amazon. And the person you see in the photograph is British. Let's have a look, shall we? Let's have another look. There it is. There it is. So there is Pedro Belmont, and the person he is with is from Britain. Thanks a lot for that. Thank you once again. Sandro Baraccini says, one romantic but very sad film was The Bridges of Madison County. I've never seen that film. I've never seen it. So it's a love story, but also a sad love story, a bit like Titanic, because we talked about Titanic earlier. We talked about the movie Titanic. Don't tell me what happens at the end. Please don't tell me what happens at the end of Titanic. I don't want to know. Don't tell me. 15 minutes to go. Just 15 minutes. Let's have another word puzzle to keep us busy for the next quarter of an hour. So there it is. Two words. So there is something for you to solve, a word puzzle, before I leave you today. But what is it? Two words. And whilst we are talking about words and phrases, let's have our final flash word, shall we? One more flash word. I am going to go over there. They say that the French are very romantic. Some people say that Italians are very romantic. Others say that English people are very romantic. I don't know how true that is. Here is today's final flash word. Are you ready? This is not a romantic word, but it is a word, an English word. Today's final flash word. Can you see it on the screen? The word is scaremonger. Scaremonger. The word scaremonger is an English noun. The word scaremonger is an English noun that means a person who creates fear and worry through their words or actions. A scaremongerer creates panic by concentrating on negative points or by exaggerating things to make them seem worse than they are. There is also the noun scaremongering, which is the spreading of frightening or fear
provoking rumours, or fear provoking rumours. We can also use scaremongering as an adjective to describe how a rumour or report is being conveyed. Your scaremongering tactics will not work. A scaremongerer is an alarmist, a pessimist, a doom and gloom merchant, a fearmonger. They spread panic. They instill fear and worry. They are a scaremonger. So there it is. Today's final flash word, scaremonger. To create fear and worry by saying certain things. And that is it for today. That is the final flash word. I do like standing up during my very long English live stream. It's very tiring doing this, you know, for 2 hours, for talking non-stop, for 2 hours. Just 11 minutes to go, and we will try to get as many of your comments in as possible. Do you believe in love at first sight? Do you want to say hello to someone who is special in your life? And your favourite Valentine's movies? There we go. That's today's word puzzle. That's the second one. And that is two words. Two words. Do you know what it is? As I mentioned earlier, this weekend it is the BAFTA Awards, the British Academy of Film and Television Arts. This weekend. And the Oscar ceremony takes place at the end of February. So the Oscars take place on the 27th of February, which is later this month. Mr. Duncan, Pathatik Dorvak says, the birds seem to be getting very hot. Yes, they seem to be getting very excited. Let's have another look, a very quick look at these love pigeons. Let's see what they're doing. Let's hope they're doing nothing rude. Let's hope it's nothing that I have to censor. Oh, there they are, look. Oh, oh, oh. Love pigeons. Two little pigeons in love with each other. Isn't that nice? So romantic. Ellis says the time is flying by very quickly. I think so. Yes, the time has gone very quickly. I can't believe we only have 9 minutes left before I go. Pedro Belmont is going. I have to go now, says Pedro. I wish you an excellent week for you, full of happiness and fun. Thank you, Pedro. Thank you for your photographs, and I will see you next week. Mr. Duncan, have you ever been to Russia? I have never been to Russia ever in my life. No, never, never, never. Jamila Borg says, today is the feast of St. Paul in Malta. I hope everything is going well there. Do you believe in love at first sight or sex at first sight? Oh, I'm not sure about sex at first sight. I mean, really, that's a bit too quick, isn't it, really? I don't think you just meet someone straight away and have sex. I think that's a bit too quick. I'm sure it happens. It happens a lot in movies and on television. But I think in real life, it doesn't happen very often. It doesn't happen very much. Saturino, thank you very much for that very interesting question. Very interesting. I will be going in a moment. I will give you the word puzzle.
because I think that I don't hold it up long enough. So I will hold it up a little longer so you can get the words, or get the letters, should I say. There we go. So there's an A, there's an O, there's an I, there's an N, T, E, N, R, D, C, R, N, M, I. But what does that spell? Two words. I will give you the answer just before I go. Thank you very much, by the way, for your comments concerning Wednesday's live English stream. I did a very special live English stream on Wednesday, eventually, because of course at first there was a problem with YouTube, but then everything was all right. I had a lovely, lovely message sent to me through a video, in fact, from Chu Shandong, and he has sent a message and a video. I'm going to play a little bit of this just for about a minute, so don't worry too much. But this is something that very kindly sent to me by Chu Shandong, who is living in the place that I used to live in when I was in China. Let's have a quick look, shall we?
Hi, Miss Duncan. This is Chu Shandong in Baotou. Baotou, do you know that? I'm sure you know that. Okay, I know. It's 10 years since you returned from China. So, I have a gift for you. Let's go. I have something to show you.
So this is where I used to live. If you were watching on Wednesday, I was talking about the place that I used to live in when I lived in China. And this place is called Baotou. Thank you very much to Chu Shandong for sending this video all the way from China. And I do recognize all of the places here in this video. I know this place very well because my house was very near. And here is a shopping center. It looks like a new shopping center. You can tell because many of the shops are still empty. So there it is, a shopping center in the place where I used to live. Oh, and look, can you see there? That looks like the British Union flag. Oh, very nice. So thank you very much to Chu Shandong for sending that video in, all the way from China, showing me the place where I used to live, the city of Baotou. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Don't forget, if you want to send anything in, if you want to send something to me, because I'm so excited today because love is in the air, you can write to my email address. Let me just show you again. Email is there. Also, my Facebook is there as well. Let's just see. There's my Facebook. Can you see it? So if you want to follow me on Facebook, you can. My email is there. And if you want to make a small donation every month to help these live lessons continue, you can also make a donation at my Patreon site as well. I am going in 4 minutes. Let's just go back to the live chat before I disappear. Mr. Duncan, why do we say been to Russia and not I've been in Russia? With places, we normally say to. So I'm going to town. I've been to town. I've been living in China. And that means you were there. You were actually in that place. But normally, after going somewhere, we have been to. I've been to England. I've been to France. I've been to Russia. So I've been there and now I have come back. I have returned. Such a nice place, Mr. Duncan. Thank you very much. That was where I used to live many years ago. 10 years ago, in fact, I was living there. If you want to see my live stream from Wednesday, it is available on my YouTube channel. You can watch it and it has subtitles. This lesson later on will also have subtitles. Not now, but later on. So there will be subtitles later on when YouTube makes my video available to watch. So don't forget, you can catch my live streams even after they have finished. It's magic. Thank you very much for this romantic live stream. Will you have an extra lesson before Friday? No, there is no extra live stream next week, just next Friday. So I will be with you live next Friday. I will write it down. There it is. So next Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. I will be with you next week. So that is when my next live lesson will be. Next Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. Next week will be... It will be the 17th. The 17th next week. Martha says, have a nice weekend, Mr. Duncan. I will have a super weekend. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. I am going to wrap up now. To wrap up means to finish or to bring something to an end. You wrap up. So I am going to wrap up today's live stream. I hope you've enjoyed it. Let's have a quick look at the love pigeons. Let's see if they are still there. They are still there. Isn't that lovely? Oh, let's say goodbye. Goodbye, love pigeons. Goodbye. I hope that you live happily ever after. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye, live pigeons. My live love pigeons. Oh, and there's a blackbird as well. Look, come to join them. Oh, he's got a worm. That's nice. And there we will end it. Thank you very much for your company today. I hope you have enjoyed what you have seen. I will be back next week. Once again, I will remind you, for those who didn't see it, next Friday, 2 p.m. UK time, is when I will be here. The word puzzle answer. There it is. The word puzzle answer. Two words. Of course. Romantic dinner was the second word puzzle. Look at that. Romantic dinner. Perhaps, maybe next week, you will be going for a romantic dinner with your loved one or your date. Who knows? I'm not sure what I'm doing yet. I have no plans for next week. Not yet, anyway. So, it's time to go. 4 o'clock has arrived. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of the English language saying thanks for following me for the past 2 hours. If you want to subscribe to my YouTube channel, you can. There is the address very quickly. That is my YouTube channel. There are hundreds of video lessons on my YouTube channel. Don't forget that. Goodbye to Victoria, Eugene, Simona, Edward, Joanna, Gridan, Rekha. Thank you very much to you all. And I will see you next Friday. Don't forget, next Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. This is Mr. Duncan once again saying thanks a lot for watching me teaching you live. Have a great weekend. Have a super week. And enjoy your Valentine's Day. I hope something romantic comes your way. And ta-ta for now.